I mean, I'm thinking of what I like doing right now is that, I mean, not thinking about legacies, or what I find important maybe as a legacy thing is to tell our story, you know, to be able to normalize our story. I mean, like, our people have like a low self-esteem, so we're not used to seeing ourselves in a certain way for starters. And it's important to have people in Attridgeville, to have a story that is just about people of Attridgeville and is unapologetic, you know, and that's what resonates, because it's so specific that it's universal. You know, I watched Matwetwe in Texas, and I watched it in Rotterdam in the Netherlands, and then I watched it in South Korea, and then the people, their reaction was more or less the same, if not exactly the same. It was like, because then all of those things, they were resonating with the same thing. The story was what it is across the board. And you like, you always see it with, when we do stand up, where as soon as you go do shows overseas, South Africans would always go, so how do you do they understand what you guys are saying there? You know, because we don't think that we are understandable as a culture in the world. You know, we don't think I think it's because of apartheid. It's because of it's not low self-esteem thing. We're not in the world. We're isolated. So white people, especially African people, like, you know, those oppressors, they were the ones who got sanctioned. You know, they were outside of the world. So when they finally got to the world, there was sort of, you know, there was not necessarily like immediately welcome, because they were seen as
still outside
people
the
pariahs. And then it was like, okay, these are those people. And then they also were feeling very insecure. They weren't like up to the, they weren't up to it. They weren't like people who thought that, okay, we are also people. They were like excluded in a way. And they were always like, are we not enough? Are we good? And they couldn't explain why, because, you know, not everybody, as much as they all benefited from apartheid and they all know what happened, nobody can immediately say what was wrong, because when you're in it, it was just a way of life. And then when you go out to the world, then you're like, whoa, you're not a cool thing, man. So that, and then they come home here, and also from the, you know, whatever they're getting out there, then in the world here where we are, where we're like more or less like their slaves, the fact that they're not up to the task of being human in the world, they also take it out on us. You know, if they're not it, then how can we be amazing? Like no, you can't be. Like, no, we're not enough. Are we good? You know, when people come here, we always ask, how do you like it? Is it, you know, like, is it up to your standard?
Yeah.
You know, is it, you're from London, you know, like those types of things. It's like world class. We say those things. It's world class. You don't hear American saying it's world class. They just assume in America it's world class.
And
you know, we say it's world class.